All right, good morning, everyone. I'm meteorologist Deitra Tate. I want to give you an update on what's happening on the radar this morning, considering, again, we are dealing with this winter storm impacting the area. As far as the Outer Banks, though, you've been dealing with just a very chilly rain throughout the morning from Manio down towards Cape Hatteras, even up towards Corrala for the most part, with the exception of a little bit of sleet mixing in. But we have had some sleet and some freezing rain reports from Hertford to Elizabeth City, and even reports of some limbs that are kind of breaking off a bit because of the weight of the ice. So be careful. Careful out there. Again, try to avoid traveling if you can. Here's a view of the south side here, and as you see, we're dealing with still a continued amount of snow that is not going to end anytime soon, though we do have some sleet pellets kind of mixing in there, indicated by the pinks. Overall, though, for the eastern shore, more snow, same deal as you make your way towards the Middle Peninsula and the Peninsula. And this is just an overview of some of the reports that we've had. Some of these reports are a little more than a half hour to an hour old, so they could definitely be higher than this. But again, we had some reports over in Hampton of about 5 inches thus far. Norfolk, 2 to 4 inches of snow reported, and even some reports of some power outages in Norfolk. As far as Reedville, about 4 inches reported earlier, about 2 inches for Deep Creek, up to around 8 inches earlier this morning, about an hour ago around the Toano area, and for Western Branch, about 3 inches, with, again, the reports of freezing rain throughout places like Hertford and Elizabeth City. Now, as far as what we're expecting in terms of totals, we're going to go with about 8 to 12 inches still for the heart of Hampton Roads, some locally higher amounts as well, but we did kind of edge back a bit because of the sleet mixing in for places like Chesapeake and Virginia Beach and down towards Elizabeth City, where, again, you've had more sleet for the onset of this system, and still in a lot of places across North Carolina, you're still dealing with sleet, so obviously your amounts would be lower. So we'll go with 4 to 8 inches anywhere from, let's say, Chesapeake, as I mentioned, Virginia Beach, as you make your way west of Elizabeth City, and then as you get from Elizabeth City eastward, the amounts are even lower than that, around, let's say, 2 to 4 inches, if that. As far as the satellite and radar view, here's the low that's creating this unsettled mess for our area. The low will continue to move towards the north and east, but this system is going to stick around throughout the day. The snow is going to remain and really not taper off until about, let's say, after midday. So unfortunately, we're going to have to deal with this through the bulk of our Saturday. Tomorrow looks much brighter, but it's still going to be very dangerous out there, considering we're going to be dealing with the slick roads, temperatures staying below freezing into tomorrow. So things are not going to melt. Plus, the winds are still going to be kicked up a bit, giving us a really bitter wind chill value into your Sunday. So through midday, again, we're expecting temperatures to stay below freezing. We're going to have winds anywhere from 25 to 35 miles per hour, gusting possibly up to 40. As we head towards 3 o'clock, you do start to see a little bit of drying from the west. And again, it'll be a gradual decrease in the snow that we see, tapering off to more of flurries and then eventually fizzling out as we head towards this evening. By 5 o'clock, still some snow holding on. Again, things drying out a bit or dwindling in terms of the snow coverage to the west. And then by 9 o'clock or so, we're looking much better as far as the snow moving out, but still the winds are going to be strong. Then we have to deal with those bitter wind chill values. A very cold night tonight. And again, the roads are going to be terrible, considering, again, no melting. So we're going to have to deal with that at least through about Monday before temperatures start to warm back up again Tuesday, getting above freezing. Here's a view Sunday morning. Again, we're looking at temperatures in the teens, and it's going to feel as if temperatures are in the single digits for the start of your Sunday. Even with the snow out of there, it's still going to be a very good day to stay inside if you can tomorrow. So as far as what to expect, through noon, steady snowfall. Again, some pockets of steady sleet if you're in North Carolina, and rain for the Outer Banks. High winds, and we're looking at low visibility. As far as between noon and 3 o'clock, the snowfall will basically peak, and we'll start to see a gradual tapering off of the snow roughly between noon and 3 o'clock, slowly from the west to the east, and it's going to remain windy with that north-northwest wind. Between 3 and 8 o'clock, we're expecting the snow to end gradually from west to east, and then we're expecting the snow that's out there to be blowing around because, again, the winds are going to stay up a bit. After 8 o'clock, still the potential for some blowing snow, some snow drifts, and we're looking at wind chill values going down into the single digits overnight. Sunday morning, again, single digit wind chill values expected. And as we head towards Sunday afternoon, even though, again, the snow is gone, it's still going to be bitterly cold out there. And because the temperatures will not get above freezing, we're looking at some icy roads that we're going to have to deal with. So check out that 7-day forecast. Again, stay inside if you can. Again, please be safe out there. If you do have to get out there on the roadways, be prepared for the wind and dangerous driving conditions. Tonight is going to be bitterly cold. Tomorrow, more of the same. Thankfully, the snow moves away. Monday, still below freezing, but by Tuesday, we get above freezing. Things hopefully begin to melt. And then by Wednesday, we'll be at around 60. But be safe out there. We'll have another update coming up at 11 o'clock.